Hey everybody, Kaden Martinson here with Leading Edge Equipment. Today we're going to go over some of the things to check on and look for with an HDF head as we get into the on-ground cutting season here in North Dakota. So this could be for your soybeans, your edible beans, things like that. We're going to be not utilizing the gauge wheels, so to speak, and cutting on-ground. I'm also going to go over two different versions of it. So the newer version, you'll see this three-way valve. Before we had a valve and a push button. And then we'll also go over the couple different things out on the end to release the cutter bar. Here's that three-way valve I was referencing. I'll shoot over to an older head here and show you the other way of it. We have a diagram. Right is open, that's for trailing, that allows it to relax. Upright is our service mode, it just locks it so it can't drop down at all. And then left is our field mode, okay? So you can see those right here. This is the same on both sides. You have a left and a right valve. Also on the left and right, you'll notice this little push button with a lock, okay? This is for the gauge wheels. We wanna make sure that we have that twisted all the way in and locked so that the gauge wheels are our indicator for the on-ground cutting. So you'll notice here we have our handle. You wanna make sure that that is upright so you can go hinging up or down. And then the push button here, the harvest mode is pushed in. So right now it's out, we'll push in and twist it clockwise. You'll hear it click in. Now we're in field mode. We're over on the right-hand side now. This will be the same on the left-hand side as it is on the right-hand side. You'll notice on the newer headers, it's on an actuator here. So I already pulled the pin out, but if you have this bottom pin in, you need to make sure your gauge wheels are down so that this is retracted out all the way so we can release that pin. And then once we pick up the gauge wheels, it'll allow it to drop. The other thing we wanna make sure we do before we pick up the gauge wheels is we wanna release the pressure out on the end. So you can see the plate here, I'll wanna back that off beforehand. This is both on older versions and newer versions if you have it. So just back off this bolt here, back out the two bolts here, and that'll allow the outside of your cutter bar to drop down. The indicator on the newer headers for this actuator to be pulled in to release that cutter bar is over on your right inner gauge wheel. So as we move around here, I'll show it to you guys. So here's our right inner gauge wheel. Right on the inside here, there's a sensor, okay? There's this little sensor right here. What happens is when this gauge wheel pulls up, it'll pull this down and push this end up, and it'll click. There's a slight click you'll hear when it lifts it up and makes contact. That click is our indicator to the controller that we're now gonna be doing on-ground cutting, and it'll also release the cutter bar, given we already have those prerequisites of dropping the plate and that pin pulled on the out-hand side. Again, this is only on the newer ones. I do have an older head over here where I can show you. Again, out on each end, each side will have this. As long as that plate's off on the bottom, you can see this eye bolt here is already taken out. We don't have a plate on this one. Here we have the turnbuckle. So with the turnbuckle pulled in, it's gonna lock up the cutter bar. As we loosen our turnbuckle, it'll push it out, it'll release our cutter bar. I like to back it all the way off for the most part to this last little stop here, and then give it a couple hand cranks back just to make sure we're not messing with any threads. Now back over on the right hand side again. Again, this will be on the left and the right on both the older and newer style of the HD heads. This piece right here is what pulls back our crop divider. So one of the things that we've seen before in soybeans is if you seem to be pushing with that crop divider out here, we'll loosen up this here. It's a little bolt with a little washer in between. You'll wanna loosen this one up, and then we can use this two nut style system to pull it up, and it will lift this up for allowing it not to push as bad out on the ends. Again, this is on both the older and the newer style HD heads. With that, we're gonna jump up in the cab and go over a couple things to check in the cab itself and on the display. Now that we're inside the cab, we're gonna start with the header settings inside the display. So I'm gonna hit my quick link down on the bottom into my header. From here, I usually start with my sensitivities and speeds at about 60. We'll wanna make sure we come in to the top and set our cut height as well, okay? So this will be our work recording height. That's where you find that. Set that to your liking of your number one lift button. From there, we'll also jump in and set our actual automatic cutter height. So I'm gonna trick on the header real quick here. I'm gonna hit my button two, and on the corner post, we'll see button two. We'll wanna scroll down our cut height until the gauge wheels are completely picked up and the corner post shows roughly zero. If it's 0.4, that's okay. We just want it all the way down into the zeros. You will then see the cutter bar release into our mechanical flex. Note, this is not a hydroflex system, okay? There's no pressures to set or anything. It's just a mechanical flex to follow the ground. Again, now we're in two and we're active in the corner, you will see your downforce come up. Again, this is not hydroflex. Instead, this is more so how much weight is out on the cutter bar or out on the header versus back on the combine itself. So as we get heavier, we're gonna be pushing more weight down out towards that cutter bar, out on the header. As we get lighter, you'll have a little bit more of the weight shifted back onto the combine. This is where we'll have to play with it in muddy conditions or drier conditions. The muddier the conditions, the more it's pushing, the more you may have to back it off into the lighter range. The more you want pressure out there to make sure you're staying down on the ground and contouring the ground a little bit better, might need to get a little bit heavier. We also have this advanced tuning option for a little bit more customizing. So you'll see up here we have a percentage, right? This is how much oil is total in there, right? This is how full our glass is. As I add, I'm making the glass more full. Down on the bottom is what I'm distributing with that glass. If I take out from over on the left-hand wing, it's putting it somewhere else. So what I like to do is try to keep the wings equal. If you feel like you need to back off the wings to keep the center push down, we'll back both of those down. Otherwise, leave them back at 50-50 and go from there. If you find yourself in a rabbit hole you can't get out of, hit the reset. It'll get you back to default settings and you can adjust from there. Now I'll close out of this screen, get back to our header screen. I'll click on the auto controls, and down on the bottom you can see resume preferences for your auto settings. This includes auto reel, auto belt, fore aft resume, and reel position resume. You can turn those on and off to your liking. The other thing I want to note is the draper belt speed. This will change with buttons 2, 3, and then 1 when you lift up. I personally, inside Beans, like to run this on the faster side, just for the fact of getting it to the center drum as fast as possible. Closing out of here now, I went over everything inside of the header page, except up in this up arrow and dot. When you click up in here, you need to make sure you have these settings installed properly. If you normally run a cross auger and you took it off, make sure to hit not installed. Gauge wheels, this is where you select standard or integrated. If you decided to put crop lifters on, make sure to check it. Again, this is all for the compensation of the settings of the controller. Also in here is where you find your wing leveling if equipped. You can have your return to height as straight across or a smile. This would happen then if you hit button 1 when you come to the ends, how you like that home position to be. When you hit button 2, it's going to go back to your normal header height sensing. All this relies though on your hinge wing position sensors. So I'm going to close out of here now and note that underneath menu, calibrations, and header, if I scroll down, this is where that hinge draper wing position calibration is. You do not, however, need to redo the header calibration if you have had a successful header calibration performed on the same machine. This is because you will pick up the gauge wheels regardless of on-ground or off-ground cutting. If you want to, you can redo the calibration and follow the steps as it shows. This header or hinge draper wing position calibration is the big one though. If you feel like one side is favoring hinging rather than the other, you may need to perform this on as flat of a surface as possible. So now that we have it in flex mode, you'll notice that all this is more of that mechanical flex that I was referring to, okay? But it can only flex to a certain extent in the middle. That is because that is where the frame is. So the actual center frame itself does not flex. You'll notice that as well from about where the feeder house meets up, just outside of that, and our hinge point. So here's our hinge point to our other hinge point, does not flex. We kind of compensate with this by utilizing our fore aft and making sure we have adjusted our reel to cutter bar distance to the best of our capabilities. If you have any questions, please reach out to us here at Leading Edge Equipment. And as always, we appreciate your business.